Today, I am sharing the $1 million checklist. These are the 5 specific things you should be doing every single day to build your brand online, which will result in increasing your income. Hey, my name is Jesse Eker, and today I'm sharing something called the Power Hour. The Power Hour is what you should be doing every single day to be building your brand online, but also increasing your income. Now, this has been inspired by a really well-known coach named Tom Ferry, who's in the real estate space, who's probably the top real estate coach in the world. And he teaches his real estate agents to do specific things, I believe it's 3 specific things every single day to make sure that they are consistently producing the outcome and the results that they want. And from his studies of surveying all the real estate agents that do these things, the average earner is earning over $200,000 just by doing that. And that's in the real estate space. What I've found in my business is that when I focus on these 5 things, I'm doing a minimum of 7 figures a year, $1 million a year. So these are 5 really easy, specific things that you should be doing every single day. Now, here's the thing. It doesn't work like, hey, by tomorrow, this is all of a sudden gonna change the name of your business. Like, your business isn't gonna change overnight. But what it does do is it compounds over time. So what I want you to imagine after I share these 5 specific things is, what's your business gonna look like in 30, 60, 90, 120 days? Just by following these 5 specific things every single day. And as you continue to do them every single day, you will continue to start getting faster, more efficient, and put more systems and processes in place so that you can maximize your time of what you're doing. So let's get into the 5 specific things to your Power Hour. Number 1, the first thing that you should be doing, making sure during your Power Hour. So power move number 1, let's just focus on existing people in our database or our existing buyers, people who have already know, like, and trust us. And the reason why this is so important to focus on number 1, like our first thing that we should be doing during our Power Hour, is because what most people are focused on is new audience, new people, new buyers, new everything, because that's what they feel like is going to help grow their business the fastest. That's partially right, but if you have a leaky bucket where all the new people just go out as fast as they come in, then you're not going to be growing. The most efficient way to grow is when your back end or your existing market is continuing to stay with you as you bring in new people. So as you bring in new people, the people in your audience goes up. And as you continue to stay in contact with people or continue to ascend people or make sure that you're taking care of people, those people go up as well. So that's where you really start to grow and build a foundation when you're taking care of both of them. So the most important thing is, these people know, like, and trust you already. And so it's much easier to take care of them just by making sure that you are reaching out to them. You're staying in contact. You're supporting them. You are making sure that they are getting their needs and wants met. So existing buyers, making sure you're reaching out to them, answering their questions, checking in on them. This could be existing database, people that you used to work with that you want to also check in as well, or people that maybe are warm or really hot to, you know, maybe purchasing or moving forward with you. These are people that you want to be reaching out to so that you're staying at top of mind. I can't tell you how important it is to stay top of mind in front of your prospects. And that's why so many people are sending so many messages, because they're always trying to stay top of mind in front of people. So the first group of people in your Power Hour is your existing market, your existing buyers, your existing database. So that's power move number 1 in your Power Hour. Power move number 2. Power move number 2 is for our leads. These are people who have shown interest in what we're doing. These are people we want to move down the sales process to get them closer to buying. These are not people who've bought before. These are people who are interested in buying or maybe have shown some interest in what you've done. This is your opportunity to engage with these people. So whether that's reaching out to them through Messenger or reaching out through an email, reaching out to just, you know, tell people what you do, right? And just kind of move them through the sales process. These could be new friend requests that you've had, people who are engaging on your videos. This could be, you know, new email addresses that you're getting. This could be, you know, your group members. If you have a group in Facebook, like reaching out to these people and just building a relationship with them, nurturing them, we call it. And again, the goal is to build a relationship so that they know, like, and trust you and understand that you're the right person to help solve their problem. So this group of people is your power move number two. And these are going to be the new people that you are bringing in as far as leads and warmer market that you can, again, move people through the sales process. Power move number three, this is the third thing that you should be doing. And this should be just follow up. The fortune is in the follow up. Too many people let too many people slide by not following up. They are just so focused on getting in conversations, but they lose so many conversations without the follow up. And remember, the fortune is in the follow up. It really is. And so when you can focus this group of people where you were in a conversation with people, you're following up. Here's an example. We had a student and they told us that after a conversation that they just wanted more information. Great. But a few days went by. We followed up with them. A few days went by. Followed up with them again, then said, I am in, and sent us $1,000. Without that follow-up, we wouldn't have got it. Now, people might say, well, that's annoying. That's just your own belief. The belief is people have lives. People are not sitting there thinking, oh, I can't wait for Jesse to follow up with me. Oh, I'm just so excited. It's like people have lives going on, all right? Think about yourself. When you are interested in something, you don't just lose interest like that. It's just like, oh, I'm not interested anymore. You're still interested, but your life has gotten in the way. Now, there is a difference between someone who's super hot, where they're like, I'm ready to go, and striking while the iron's hot, and someone who's cold, who's kind of like, let it go. Now, the difference is the touch points of when you are conversating with these people. So if you wait too long of the conversation, yes, they can start to see other messages, they can start to double think things, they can start to, you know, cool off. But that's why you want to follow up. And that's why power move number three is following up with the people you are in conversations with, people that you are maybe have said, I'm not interested right now, and maybe in the future, people who you need to just continue to stay in contact with. Follow up, follow up, follow up. Power move number four. This is all about building your audience. So one of the most important things that we just talked about was kind of your audience already. So we talked about your existing audience. These are like buyers or people who you want to stay in contact with. You know, you have existing buyers, okay? Then you have the new people, new leads, new people that have you've recently gone in contact with, and you want to, you know, either continue that conversation or you want to just reach out to them to start the conversation so that you have are moving people through the sales process. And then you're following up people who maybe have said that they are interested at one point, or you want to keep the conversation going, all right? So you have existing, new, and follow up. Those are the audience that you're working with for the first three power moves. But the fourth power move is building your audience. We want to make sure that we're replenishing our ecosystem. We want to make sure that we are continuously building that audience so that we continue to grow our ecosystem. And the way that we decide to do that is we got to go find our people. We got to build our audience. And there's lots of great ways to do this. I want you to pick and choose one or two that's going to work for you. So number one, there's lots of great groups online. There is Facebook groups, which have tons of different markets. It's like an interest for any different topic and filled with people who said, that's me, that's who I am, right? So you can build relationships in there and build your audience through that. There's LinkedIn groups. Those are great ways as well. There is people who have built audiences themselves. Like if you look online to like some sort of Instagram page, they might have like 100,000 followers. Who are these 100,000 followers, and why are they following this person? Well, they're putting out content for specific people. So if you match that contact, that's different markets that you can start to build relationships with, all right? So building the audience there. You can get on people's podcasts, you can get on interviews, you can get on summits, you can get in different people's groups to be featured. There's tons of different ways. You can have people that you already know spread the word around you. Right? There are so many different strategies and tactics for building your audience. You just gotta pick and choose which one resonates with you and which one you are consistently going to do. Anything from 10 to 20 minutes a day, that's all you need. Just go ahead and build that audience. How do you build it? You make relationships, just like you would build a friendship, right? You'd actually go in and, you know, add some value, contribute, show your expertise, show your authority, and build an audience, all right? So once you start to do that with people who don't know who you are, they start to take note to who you are, right? And then they come into your ecosystem, so they maybe follow you, join your Facebook group, friend request you, whatever it is, they join your ecosystem, and that's where power move number 5 comes in, which is building your authority. Building your authority is really showcasing why you are the right person to help solve someone else's problem. So I help experts and coaches build brands online. That's what I do. I help experts and coaches build 7-figure brands online. And so when they come to my ecosystem, my goal and hope is that they see that I can help them do that. And so what can you help someone do? What's your one-liner that you can help someone do? And are they gonna be able to notice that when they come to your profiles, to your database, to what you're doing? Is your message speaking to that? Right? So building your authority is putting out message, videos, content, posts, in some way is gonna add value to helping someone know, like, and trust you so they want to get into conversation with you or move forward with you down the sales cycle. So that's the power hour. It's 5 specific steps that you can do every single day. You can do anywhere from 10 minutes, 5 minutes, 5 minutes or 10 minutes or 15 minutes or 20 minutes or 30 minutes on each move, whatever, however long you wanna make it. But I would say suggest it to keep it to 1 hour only. 1 hour, because then you can start to, you know, focus, and you can start to become more efficient, and you can start to really start to figure out how do you make this work in an hour or less, right? And so obviously you can do the 15 minutes each, but sometimes some things are gonna take longer, some things are gonna take shorter. So right now this video is taking about 16 minutes. That's a little longer than 15 minutes, right? So, you know, this is part of my build authority and part of my power hour, okay? So let me just recap this really fast, because I'd love to know, out of the 5, which one resonates most with you? Number 1, existing people, existing buyers, existing people who have said yes to you in the, before, keep them in your side, keep them in your ecosystem. Number 2, new people, people you've never talked to before, people that, you know, you wanna reach out to, new leads, new people that you want to bring down the sales cycle. 3, following up with people, making sure that you are following up with people that, you know, you were in conversation with or that are potentially interested in what you wanna do, you wanna continue to follow up with them. Whether that is in a manual way or an automated way, they work the same way. Number 4, we wanna build our audience, making sure that we are expanding our ecosystem, whether that's using organic strategies, paid strategies, or referral strategies. And number 5 is we wanna build our authority, making sure that the people that are coming into our ecosystem are realizing that we are the right person to help them solve their problems. Which one of these are gonna resonate most with you? And I wanna make sure that you are committed to this power hour. So in the comments below, let's put, I am committed to the power hour, and also let me know which one of the 5 resonates with you. Thank you for watching this video. I appreciate your time. I appreciate your attention. And let's go take some massive action to make this power hour become a reality and watch your business absolutely crush it 30, 60, 90 days from now. Bye for now, and I will talk to you soon.